Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm going to show you how to take raw data and find the measures of central tendency and the measures of variation. I'm using a data set today about cereal, and I'm going to have you compare the ratings of the cereal from the manufacturer K and the manufacturer G. I can't tell you what the rating means, I don't know, but I am going to say that we're going to make a decision about the rating with the idea that a lower rating is bad and a higher rating is good, because that's probably how it is. But because I want to compare K and G, I want to first sort by K and G. So I'm going to click on that B column and make sure it's highlighted, and come over here and click Sort A to Z. It's going to ask, do you want to expand the selection? What that means is, if we move this K, do you want to move everything in the row along with it? And we do. So yes, keep that expand the selection and then hit Sort. Now we've sorted all the G down to all the K. And I want you to notice that my G goes from B2 down to B23. So we're going to remember 2 to 23 are G values, and after that are K values. Now I'm going to come over here and click on ratings. Now I can just click on the left and just drag down to highlight that, which would work just great. The other thing you can do is click on that column, the top, and hit Control, Shift, and down arrow. And that's going to highlight that column. It will stop where there's a break. So that's a nice little thing. And then Control C, that is copy. Then I'm going to come over here and click on the plus at the bottom to create a new sheet. And I'm going to just click on that first rectangle in the top and hit Control V, which now paste all that in there. And I'm just going to go ahead and center that while I'm at it. Next thing I'm going to do is make a new column called Rating for K. And this first one I'm actually going to call Rating for G. So I'm separating those. Now remember, 2 through 23 was our G cereals. You could always go back to the old sheet and check that out, but I just happen to remember that. So I'm going to come down here to 24, because that's where the K cereal started. And I'm going to highlight, I'm going to drag down and highlight down to 53, that's cell 46. And I'm going to Control C to copy. And actually, I'm going to Control X, because I want to get rid of that down there. So I just Control X. And then click on here and Control V. That pastes. So I got rid of everything below 23 and I put it into its own column. Now I have two columns of data that I'm working with. Now there's several things that I want to show you how to find, and I'm not going to remember them in order. So I'm just going to come over here and copy this. Just drag down and copy it, Control C, and then go back to my sheet and click on where I want that to be. I'll start here in Control V, and there's my all those values that I wanted. I can come up here to the top and pull that out a little bit to change the width. Now, I'm assuming that you don't know how to use Excel. So I'm showing you kind of painstakingly and sometimes multiple ways to do things. But if you know how to use Excel and you know shortcuts that are better than what I'm using, that's what you should do. There's so many different ways to get there. So I'm going to do all the stuff for G first, the minimum value. Well, I could sort this and find the minimum value myself, but I'm going to use the formula. So go up here to formulas and then click on more functions and then statistical. And we're going to find the minimum value by dragging down here and clicking on min. And it's going to ask you what values should we be using. And I'm going to click on 2, and then I'm going to use that trick. Control, Shift, down arrow. And that's going to take me down from A2 to A23. Do you see how that is? A2, semicolon, A23. That's saying those are all the values that we're looking at. Then just click on OK. But before I do that, I'm going to copy this, A2 to A23, because that's what I'm going to use every time. And once I have that, I can just paste that in quickly. Click on OK. There's your minimum value. I'm going to do the same thing. You could type in equals max, because that's the function that you need. But if you don't know that, you can go down and find it on your list. Once you find max, click on it, and then go. It's already highlighted here, so just go ahead and control paste. If you copied A2 to A23, that's what we're going to keep using. For the mean, we're going to look at the arithmetic mean, and it's average on here. Click on average. Again, copy and paste if you had it. Let's say that you didn't have it copy and pasted. You could actually type in A2 colon A23. that would be fine. As long as it gets the message and you've coded that incorrectly, you're okay. Median, more functions, statistical. Go down to median. The median is also the second quartile. You can copy and paste it. You can type it in like I just said, or you could come over here again and click on the top one and then control shift down, and that's going to take it down to that last value. So I'm not going to keep showing you multiple ways to do it, but I wanted to show you each of those a few times. Statistics down to mode. We're going to look at mode single. And again, I'm just going to paste those values in, and that's going to be it. Standard deviation. I'm not explaining what these mean. That's other videos you need to watch. This is just how to do this in Excel. We're looking at standard deviation for a sample, and this copy and paste, or paste it. Just control V to paste. The range is just the difference between the max and the min, and you can do that in here, but it's easier just to say 52 minus 20 is 32. Because there's no function specifically for range. All right, variance is going to be the square of our standard deviation. Make sure when you choose it that you're choosing standard deviation for a sample. And again, paste those values in or highlight the cells as you see fit. The first quartile, we're going to go down to the quartile, EXC. And this one has a little bit more to it. We're going to put in the values, and then they need to know what quartile. So click in that, and it'll say minimum value. Well, minimum value is the zero quartile. Well, we already know the minimum value. Median is the second quartile. We want to know the first quartile. So we're just going to put one in here and click enter. And then we're going to go to the last one, and we're going to do the same thing again. Go down to quartile and put that in again. And then instead of one, we want the third quartile, and then click OK. Then you can come over here to these values that have really long decimals. Click on home and go here to this button. And it, if you hover over it, it says decrease the decimal. Click on that down to two. Let's say we want two decimals. If it's not a whole number, we'd like it to just be two. And you can do that for all the ones that have these big long decimals. The value is still there, but it looks nicer for us. We're going to do the same thing for K. So if you already got it and you don't need to watch the second half of that, that'd be great. Remember that for K, we're not looking at A2 through A23 anymore. We're looking at B2, control shift down to B24, right? And then we want to hit that parentheses at the end and hit enter. So that would give us that. If we wanted the max, we could go to formulas and more functions and statistical and down to max. And then here I could type in B2 semicolon B24 because that's what I really want. I'm going to copy that right now so I don't have to type that in every time. Control C copies it, and then I hit OK. And then I can come into the mean. Remember, the mean is the average, and we're talking about it. Arithmetic mean, paste the B2 to B24, and there you go. And the median is the median, is the second quartile, I mean. The median is the median, yes, that's true. And I can just copy paste, put that in there. Remember, when you get to the range, just do the subtraction. That's the easier way to do it. You can do it more complicated ways using this program, but mode single, control paste, OK, standard deviation, scroll down, make sure it's the S, and paste. You can see how quick that is once you know what you're going to be doing. The range is 94 minus 30 or 64 here. The variance is the standard deviation squared. Variance of S, it's our B2 to B24, the first quartile, quartile EXC, went past it. This one I want to do the range of my data, and I also want to say I'm looking for the first quartile, and then I want to do it for the third quartile. my range and my third quartile. And now you've got measures of center and measures of variation. And remember, click on home and hit that decimal to decrease that decimal value. It does not actually decrease it for formula purposes, but it does decrease it for visual purposes. And then if we highlight that and click on all borders, that kind of gives us a nice chart. That's the first part of your assignment. Have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.